So this is an example of what we call the nonlinear system of equations, because again, we have the square root of x and also the square root of y. So do you think that we should just use the usual approach? Meaning that maybe just do this by substitution, maybe add a y on both sides and then plug that expression to here and then try to work that out. What do you guys think? Well, you know the deal, please pause the video and try this first. I'll give you guys a hint. There's only one answer, so it's not so bad. And if you see how to do this the quick way, then yeah, it will be actually very quick, of course. Done? No, not yet? Okay. You can just pause the video, you know, you don't really need to wait for me. So let's just go ahead and do it. Okay, do not do substitution. That will be a little bit too long. Check this out, much faster. Here we have x minus y, and these are square roots, yeah? X, it's the same as square root of x. Square. Aha, maybe some of you guys see this already, huh? Okay, minus y, it's the same as square root of y, and then we square, and this is equal to 85. Why do we do that? Yes, you are right. This is now a difference of two squares, so we can do this by factoring. We can factor this and we will end up with square root of x minus square root of y times square root of x plus square root of y. And then that will give us 85. And check this out. We do know square root of x plus square root of y is equal to 17. That's exactly right here. So that means we can just say square root of x minus square root of y times 17. It's equal to 85. And of course, we can just divide the 17 on both sides, and this will give us square root of x minus square root of y being equal to 85 divided by 17. That is equal to 5. Very, very nice. Now, I'm just going to look at this equation, which is square root of x plus square root of y being equal to 17. And then the other equation is that, namely square root of x minus square root of y being equal to 5. So much better, so much better, because this system of equations, we have this and that being the same, but opposite sign. So if we add them up, aha, we will get 2. Square root of x being equal to this and that will just be 22, and of course they cancel. So now we can just work this out. Divide the 2 on both sides, we get square root of x being equal to 11, and then square both sides, and we get x is equal to 121. Cool, huh? And we can just put 121. This is not absolute value of 2. This is 121. Put this back to the first equation, so we get square root of 121 plus square root of y being equal to 17. Okay, this is 11. I'm going to subtract 11 on both sides, so we get square root of y being equal to 17 minus 11 is 6, and then we can just square both sides again, cancel, y is equal to 36. So, ladies and gentlemen, the answers are x is equal to 121 and y is equal to 36. And if you would like, you can also put it as 121, 36, up to you. What I mean by that is like to put it as the word of the pair, 121, 36, yeah.